Hey, what's going on everyone? Gareth here, FCP Euro. Welcome back to another DIY video. Today, I'm gonna show you how to replace an oil cooler on this F30 328i on the lift behind us. All right, so in the world of N-series BMW engines, the N52, N54, N55, S55, N20, N26, there's two different type of oil coolers that those engines will have. This particular application is going to use an oil to water cooler on the oil filter housing, and that's what we're going to be replacing specifically. The other style is going to have your oil cooler, which is basically a radiator, somewhere in the wheel well with an oil cooler thermostat on the oil filter housing. Oil filter housings are basically the same in that case. They use the same gasket, but we're only going to be focusing on this style cooler, which has the oil to water heat exchanger pretty much built into it. In this car's case, coolant is basically leaking out in this sandwich plate. You can kind of see it was spraying everywhere. Pretty common failure, so we need to go ahead and replace that. While we're at it, we're gonna also change the oil. We are gonna drain the oil, and we also need to drain coolant to do this because coolant does flow through this. But with that said, let's talk about some of the tools we need to do this job, and we'll go ahead and jump right into it. All right, so some of the tools we need to the oil cooler on this N20 engine. You're gonna need an E12 Torx socket, 10 millimeter, 8 millimeter socket for removing the under tray from the car. I do recommend doing that just to avoid any mess. Plus, you're gonna have to drain some coolant. A 2 or 3 inch 3/8 extension, unless you have a deep E12. In this car's case, it has a 10 millimeter Allen for the oil drain plug. I am gonna drain the oil. And since I'm replacing the oil filter at the same time, if you have a stock oil filter cap, you'll want an 86 millimeter 16 flute cap socket. We do carry that at fcpeuro.com. Got a 3/8 ratchet, a 3/8 torque wrench that can do 20 newton meters, 23 newton meters of torque. Of course, an impact gun for removing all those 8 millimeter or 10 millimeter screws underneath the car. I have one of these hose clamp pliers for removing your spring style hose clamps, which is on the feed hose to the oil cooler. And then having one of these little picks is gonna be useful for removing the gasket. Other than that, I'm gonna use a vacuum filler for refilling the cooling system and also checking for cooling system integrity. And then past that, you know, a funnel for refilling the oil if you're doing oil change at the same time. But that's really all it's needed for doing this job. Pretty straightforward. So the biggest thing here is because this heat exchanger has coolant and oil flowing through it, I want to reduce the mess in this engine bay as much as humanly possible. So I'm going to be draining the coolant, and I'm also going to do an oil change at the same time. This engine is fairly new to this car. It's going to be the second oil change, so I'm expecting some debris to be in the oil filter just from the rod bearings we put in it. But that said, really want to reduce the potential mess here. So we'll drain coolant from the radiator and we will remove oil from the oil filter housing. And that should, in theory, prevent a huge mess from generating. Crack this. Okay, lift the car up. The lowest point in the cooling system for this one, because it's an M Sport or Sport line, is going to be at one of the auxiliary radiators. You can drain from there. Simply disconnect one of the hoses and you should be able to get most of the coolant out in one shot. And taking the expansion tank cap off allows the system to drain. So otherwise, if you open it, it's gonna like do the glug because it creates a vacuum in the system. Just pop that quick connect back on. We'll put our oil drain plug back on. Next up, take the oil filter out. I'm gonna be replacing it. Also, removing the oil filter is going to allow for any residual oil inside the oil filter housing to drain back into the oil pan. All right, next up we have this hose clamp which goes to the oil cooler. I'm gonna loosen that. then we should be able to pull this off and there shouldn't be any coolant in there, theoretically. That's why we drained the coolant. That's good, no mess, we like that. And now we have three E12 Torx bolts or screws that hold the oil cooler to the oil filter housing. So we'll break those loose. And put a rag underneath the oil cooler just in case any oil likes to come out or wants to come out, we'll catch it. There we go. You can see right here, this is how the oil cooler seal fits. Oil comes through here and here, coolant passes through there. So coolant comes up through here, comes out the bottom. And everything got cleaned up, but we saw a bunch of coolant kind of collected around here. So it was seeping out in between. Each one of these is a layer. It's kind of like a radiator. And coolant was coming out through externally, so it was leaking. Install the oil cooler seal. Worth noting, there was an update to these. You really want to install the new style, which is made out of a fluoride rubber. It's like FPM, I think. The original gaskets were Buna. One of the differentiating design differences is the original style gasket doesn't have nubs to keep it in place, whereas the new one does. And of course, while you're doing this, just make sure that the gasket doesn't move inside the oil filter housing. It shouldn't. But it'd be really unfortunate to do all this work to have had the gasket shift and then leak. So now I'm gonna torque these oil filter housing screws or oil cooler screws to 23 newton meters. And we'll install the coolant feed hose to the oil cooler. The clamp is bonded to the hose, so it kind of stays in place, which is great. It's also a self-tensioning clamp, so you don't have to worry about over-tightening or anything like that. We're good there. Pop on your oil filter. I am committing a sin. The O-rings I'm not replacing because literally there's probably 150 miles on those O-rings, so it's gonna be okay. It's gonna be just fine. And we're gonna pour in 5 liters of our favorite oil here. At this point, at least on these N-series engines, they do have a self-bleeding procedure that you can follow. So basically you're gonna power the car on, turn the temperature all the way up, fan speed to the lowest, put your foot on the accelerator pedal for 10 seconds. Obviously the car's not running. That'll turn on the electric water pump. The electric water pump will cycle coolant, move the thermostat, fill the heater core, et cetera, and help bleed out any residual air that could be in the system. But that's all it takes to replace the oil cooler, at least a air or oil to water cooler on these N series engines. Of course, it's gonna be different depending on which car you're working on, but the general process is gonna be the same. Anyway, I hope you learned something. If you have any questions or comments, leave them in the comment box below. If you like this video, hit the like button. And of course, you'll want to hit subscribe because we have lots of content like this on the way. And as always, we'll see you for the next one. Thanks for watching.